So, students, we are back with the second module of substitution at the aliphatic carbon. And in the previous module, we have spoken about SN1 type of reactions. And in second module now, we will be talking about the SN2 type of reactions. So, in this module, we'll be able to understand what is SN2 reaction, how it takes place, what is the mechanism. I want to talk about kinetic study of this reaction and stereochemistry of SN2 reaction, as well as we'll check some of the factors which would affect the rate of SN2 reaction. So what is SN2 reaction? SN2 stands for bimolecular nucleophilic substitution. S stands for substitution, N stands for nucleophilic, and 2 stands for bimolecular. Now, this is a one-step reaction in which a bond between leaving group and the carbon atom is partially broken and a nucleophile starts attacking to the carbon atom to give a transition state which immediately breaks down to give you product where now the leaving group is replaced by nucleophile. All these things happen in same step, in a single step, and therefore we say that it is a single step reaction. Obviously, since it is a single step reaction, that becomes a rate determining step for your SN2 reaction. And in this particular step, since both nucleophile as well as substrate both are involved, rate of the reaction will depend upon the concentration of substrate as well as nucleophile. Therefore, the rate equation, we write it as rate is directly proportional to concentration of substrate and nucleophile, and hence this reaction is called as bimolecular reaction. So, it is observed that in this particular reaction, the nucleophile approaches exactly from the backside of the leaving group to give you the product. So, the orientation of nucleophile will be exactly to the opposite side of the leaving group. And generally, primary substrates undergo this kind of reactions. So, more details you can see in this particular reaction. Now, let's say this is your nucleophile. Let's say this is your hydroxyl group. This red circle indicates that it is the oxygen atom, which has a negative charge and therefore it is electron-rich center. This is your substrate. Let's say any primary alkyl halide. So, it has a carbon. For example, this is now chloride. So, this is CCl bond is a polar covalent bond. And Cl is your leaving group. So, when a hydroxyl group first starts approaching to this particular carbon, which is partially positively charged, to give you a transition state. In this transition state, now a bond between the nucleophile and carbon is partially formed, whereas a bond between carbon and leaving group is partially broken to give you the transition state, which is a very high energy state. Obviously, it is unstable and it immediately falls down into a product where now you'll find that hydroxyl group is attached to this carbon and leaving group has departed, detached from your substrate. The orientation of your leaving group and the nucleophile, if you see, they are exactly at opposite side, and therefore we say that this particular reaction takes place with inversion of configuration. It is observed that generally strong anionic nucleophiles speed up this rate of reaction. The nucleophilicity of the incoming nucleophile will be more if it has more negative charge and will enhance the rate of reaction, as well as it is observed that polar aprotic solvent like acetone, they favor this particular reaction. They enhance the rate of SN2 type of reaction, but polar solvents like water, they reduce the rate of reaction. Polar solvent, protic solvents are good for SN1, whereas polar aprotic solvents are good for SN2 type of reaction. The stability of the anion of the leaving group, that means this leaving group, once it goes, it is in the form of anionic form. It has departed with the lone its pair of electrons. If this particular anion form is stable, then rate of reaction of SN2 will also be higher or the faster. So if I take now example of an unsymmetrical 2-bromobutane where you have a chiral center over here. Let's see how this reaction takes place. So your hydroxyl group over here is a nucleophile and this is your reaction center. Br is a leaving group. So let's say this yellow is Br and this is your OH, okay, nucleophile. So it starts coming and approaching this carbon and forms a transition state. Now what is this transition state? Just now we have seen that this particular carbon has these three bonds in the same plane, but hydroxyl and your nucleophile, hydroxyl nucleophile and leaving group, they are opposite to each other. This is your transition state of your SN2 type of reaction. Once this happens, then obviously a very high energy state has come and this particular hydroxyl will form a strong bond, whereas your leaving group will depart to give you a product. Now this is how the product will look like. So here now a new bond is formed between a carbon and the nucleophile, that is your oxygen atom of hydroxyl group. So this is how you can represent show a model for SN2 type of reaction. So same mechanism can be written now. So I have understood that since Br also in polarization, Br has negative charge, partial negative charge, and your incoming nucleophile is also negatively charged. If it comes from the same side, there will be a repulsion between them because they have like charges. So hydroxyl has to come from back side of the leaving group. If it comes from the back side, we get a transition state where now the hydroxyl has formed partial bond with this particular carbon and Br is bond with this carbon is partially broken and high energy state because it has a charge and it is a high energy state is formed, that is called transition state. It is unstable. This is a slow step and then fast step takes place where now Br will depart from this particular transition state and hydroxyl will remain from to the opposite side of this Br. So what we'll find, the orientation of your reactant and product groups, it is totally opposite from or they will resemble like a mirror images of each other. And therefore we say that whenever a SN2 reaction takes place at the chiral center, you'll find that there is a inversion of configuration. The hydroxyl group over here, that is nucleophile, is exactly opposite to this Br, which is a leaving group. So this is how we represent our SN2 type of reaction. And this is how we will talk about the stereochemistry of this. So we have understood that it is a inversion of configuration. One more example, we'll see that your SH, your sulfur has negative charge, is a nucleophile and Cl is a leaving group. So obviously the reaction center is over here. This is a polar covalent bond. So SH will come. Now since Cl is to the alpha side, SH will come from the beta side and you will get a product where now there is inversion of configuration, or we'll say that incoming nucleophile and your leaving group, they are in the opposite planes. So another example you can show here, mid CH3O minus becomes your nucleophile, Br is a leaving group. Now you can see here that there is a F and there is Br. This CF bond is also polar covalent bond. CBr is also polar covalent. But then we need to see that which one is a good leaving group. So if you compare fluoride and bromide, you find that Br is a better leaving group as compared to F, and therefore here Br is replaced by OCH3 to give the product, and you get a product with the inversion of configuration. Now if I try to understand this inversion of configuration, that doesn't mean that every time R will be converted to S or S will be converted into R. We'll take this example only. If I, you know that how do we find out the RS configuration? If I find out priority for Br will be 1, then fluorine will be 2, carbon will be 3 and hydrogen will be 4, and if I join this, it becomes a S configuration. Now when methoxy comes, again we'll check the priorities. Now what happens? The priority of fluoride becomes 1. Here it was 2, Now it has become one, and the oxygen gets second priority. So the product also has configuration S. But still, we say that there is inversion of configuration, because the orientation of these three groups, if I compare with the reactants and products, will find that there is total opposite, it is gone to opposite side. You can see that they are to the left hand side in your reactant, and they have gone to right hand side in the product. So we call this as an inversion of configuration. So if I study the kinetics, as I told you, that rate is directly proportional to concentration of both substrate as well as nucleophile, and therefore it is called bimolecular. So if this is the energy of reactants, it goes to transition state, which is a higher state, energy state, and then it falls down into product. The energy of product will be always less than energy of reactant, and this energy barrier between the transition state and the energy of reactant is called as energy of activity.